So, hello everyone. I'm Mathieu Simonin, and I will remove my shirt. No, I'm sorry. And today I'm gonna talk about tools. So today is about this talk is about malware classification for Android. But you will know nothing about how we do classification and how we build the classifier. But the talk is more about how we evaluate classifiers in the literature. So the talk is entitled State of the Art Android Machine Learning Based Detection System at Your Fingertips. It's a work made with David Bombet from White Team. So I'm mostly interested in experimentation part of the scientific work, and mostly in distributed systems. So I have some contribution with different teams in this field. Basically, for those who are from Rennes, I did not expect people from outside actually. So for those who are in Rennes, Myriad, Y, Calata, Stack Team, maybe you have heard of them. This is the team I'm used to work with. But for also those who are from Rennes, sorry, a small advertisement here. I'm organizing some meetings about experimentation practice, which is called the XUG meeting, which is right there. If you have the slides, you can click on the link somehow. So I let you check the coming session. So the Zoom meeting is more about talks and tutorials about experimentation practices. Okay, and we will have in a few, hopefully, some new events, regular events about problem solving session, which will be called Ask the Zed. So it's for people from Rennes, sorry for the other. So recently, I've been interested in malware classification methodology. So to limit a bit the scope of the talk, I will only talk about static analysis. Okay, I'm just using static analysis for different reasons, with some scale requirements, meaning I'm interested in running such an analysis at a certain scale, like 1 million application, let's say. My environment of work is basically made of two things: my local machine for my mail, and Grid 5000 for my analysis. Okay, so I'm also interested in how we can do stuff here and how we can move smoothly from here to here, okay, from the local machine to the grid very smoothly. This is a topic I'm interested in. The context here is about classification. So at the left part of the picture, you have your application, and you want to know if it's a malware or if it's not a malware. So basically, you based your evaluation on a function C that will tell you if X is 0 or 1. 0 is it's not a malware, 1 is a malware. If you look at the literature on this field, there are some contributions that focus on actually building the classifier. Okay. And the claim of such paper is something like, here is my new classifier, and I'll show you how I've built it and how it performs. As Teddy Furons presented us, there are also the start of something. We see the rise of some contribution, new contribution about building adversarial examples or anything that can poison your classifier. So. We talked just before about black box and white box as an example. This is typically some new contribution that are coming in this field, okay, poisoning and so on. I learned that there are also other stuff here, so I was not aware of that. And basically, these papers are about, okay, I built a data set that can evade this classifier, and I will show you how we make this data set. And there are some less contribution that focus on the overall methodology of how we evaluate these two things. Okay, and it's about reproducibility of the evaluation of these two contributions, bias and quantification. We'll talk about that in a bit. And evaluation of the bias. So it's important to measure what are the bias, the possible bias in your evaluation. So it brings basically nuances to the two other contributions. Yes, your classifier is maybe good in this very specific setting, but if you change this setting, like if you change the data set, maybe it's not that good. Okay? So you need to measure that. And the three kinds of the contribution are basically complementary. So this contribution brings feedbacks to how these two are evaluated. So in a supervised context, it looks like this. It's let's fancy that orange tree dashboard. Okay, basically it's the same. You start with a dataset of applications. So it's a real application that you can install on your smartphone if you want. Okay, there is a first step that consists in extracting some features. So here are some. This is the core of some contribution. How we can extract interesting features from the application. You need some ground truth, which is basically a function also that for each APK tells you if the APK is a malware or is a goodware. This is an external knowledge on your dataset. And then, once you have done build your X and Y, you can train classifier, test it, and score it. Okay? The way you train or test your dataset depends on the selection method, model selection method, like I will do a cross-validation or a 5-fold cross-validation, a 10-fold cross-validation, and so on. There are some baseline in the literature for those who know a bit, but I will maybe take this one. Rubin is a very famous paper for historical reason. It makes the evaluation on some applications, 5K malware and more than 100,000 malware. The core of the contribution is here, how they extract the features. So this is really the core of the contribution here of the paper. The ground truth was based on VirusTotal, which is basically an API that you can request to know if an application can be misclassified as malware or goodware. This is very moving. Basically, if you request the same set of APK today, you will not end with the same ground truth that has been used for Draven at that time. So it's kind of not reproducible. Okay. They use an SVC, and they use this split, this ratio for the split. Okay, train 66% and test 32%. So you can do the same exercise for all papers. So basically a paper, an evaluation of a classifier in a paper consists in applying this function. Okay. And in any case, if you build a new classifier, or if you study some classifier, if you build a dataset that evades the classifier, I don't know what contribution you can do, you will have to introduce some variations here, okay? Because you want, if you have built a new classifier, you will test your classifier against the dataset, but you will also compare your classifier with other classifiers from the related works. So basically, you will change at least this the classifier, you will put your own, and then you will compare with other classifier of the literature. Okay? But you can change also the data sets, and you will get other scores and so on. So there is a need for introducing some variations. Okay? And if I wrote this like that, variation is changing the parameters of the function even. So this is an example of a classical variation of in two dimensions, but it's not in the field of malware classification for Android. If it's in the field of time series classification, I would like you to have a sense of what is done in this community. Okay, in this community, when you have a new classifier, you will test it against 85 datasets. Okay, which are the references? It's called UCR. And if you can also, so you need to scale this dimension, the number of data sets, okay? And you can scale also on the dimension of the number of the models. So you will test, I think, the introduced classifier is this one. It has been tested, it has been compared to 9 other classifiers, okay? And then you can draw some good statistics out of this, okay? So they are used to, in this community, to test their classifier against several data sets, which are the reference, and also other state-of-the-art models. Yep.
The column at left is only Android APK data set?
No, it's time series. It's in the time series community. So here, basically, Each line is a dataset composed of time series. Okay, it's not, it's here, it's not from Android malware classification community. And that's the problem, I guess. Because the question we can ask is how we dare in the Android malware classification context. Basically, I mean, can we do the same, replacing the dataset with some dataset of application, and can we do the same here, replacing the classifier here with malware classification in the Android context? And the answer is, we are not quite there, for several reasons, okay? And if I look at my evil function, so the things I need to run to evaluate a classifier, there are some parameters that are easy to tune to make value, and there are some other parameters that are not so easy to tune. For example, this C is very easy. You have seen that this morning. This morning we just changed the widget on the Orange toolbox, and we put an arrow and we changed the C. It was very easy to change this C. Okay? So here, it's very easy to introduce some variations. Regarding these three things, my feeling is that it's not that easy, and actually it's a pain, because, for example, the dataset, we don't have any reference datasets. We don't have this. So from the experimental point of view, it's very uncomfortable to work without knowing on which dataset I should test my new classifier. Okay? And the same for the feature extraction method. So my feature extraction method and my ground truth, I don't know, especially ground truth. Ground truth is not something that is well established. Okay? Regarding also the datasets, if you look at the literature, many of them are unavailable or deprecated. Okay, so you have some issue here. And also from the code point of view of the evaluation, you have a tight coupling between the dataset and the way features are extracted, which is also something that makes uncomfortable, that makes this parameter not easy to change. This is where Andromaque comes into play. The idea of Andromaque is to fix this DFM-GT coupling by trying to decoupling them. And the goal is actually to allow experimenters to build easily various evaluations and to also use this tool as a knowledge base, meaning that in the tool we have some reference algorithm, feature extraction method, but also default classification model and default datasets available, so that you can reproduce some of the state of the art and compare with your own. Okay, let me skip the design principle. So what's inside the Andromaque? We have the support for 5 datasets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which is not 85, but it was already a pain. Okay, because if you look at, once again, in the literature, it's really hard to find datasets that are available and useful. Okay, so here, the main leader is one you know, GM19, because it's from C.team. And how we do that? We have a store abstraction in the library, which is a way we interact with datasets. It's just in direction layer. But it provides a common API to manipulate datasets, manipulate APKs. Okay. We also have the support for various feature extraction methods. The same here, if you look at the literature, it's very hard to find implementation that works, that still works. For some of them, we have recoded some of them, but only 5, and it was really not that easy, actually. But if you want to plug a new one, it's quite easy. Since it's an extraction method, you need to provide 2 functions, at least. An extract function that will take an APK and a feature. So the role of the library is to feed your function with the right thing here, and then you write the logic to go from there to the feature, which is kind of obvious. But the thing is that the library, if provide you a way to run this extract method at scale. Okay, they can deploy this extract method on 1 million APK the same way it can run it on 1 APK. Okay, we'll stop. You can also provide a dump function for optimization purpose, because dealing with 1 million application, you need to do some optimization on the storage. For those who know, we use Dask behind the scene to transparently run the extract function on a big cluster of machine or on your local machine. This is a picture of the Dask dashboard. So here I was extracting 1 million the feature of the build for 1 million application. It took some time, but at least it worked. It worked almost, because you will learn also that there is a caveat working with real application, is that you cannot extract the feature for all the applications. So there are some applications that are reluctant to be extracted. So it's a pain actually, because how do you compare stuff when you cannot base your study on the same data set, basically? Okay? So we have the same, we have some default classifier from the state of the art if you want to run for reproducibility purpose, but if you want to add a new one, it's very easy. We have also some support for specific model selection method. So this morning we used, I guess, train split, the quite famous train split, but here you can do a time over split, which allows you to measure basically the drift of your model over the time. So in these two picture, we have two data sets that are timestamped. Okay, so we train until a certain point of time before the graph starts, and then we test on the subsequent years or months, and we report the performance here. I guess it's the F1 score, and we can see that the F1 score is dropping over the time. Okay, it's a way to select model. Of course, you will select the model that have the biggest area under the curve, for example. And on top, since we have decoupled things, we can build this kind of table. And you can see that changing, for example, the data sets. So for this, it's a variant of the same algorithm. But what is important here is to check that here you have a very nice number. But if you change the data set, you have a very not that nice number. Okay? And you can compare the variance between each other here on the other axis. So, as a conclusion, Androvac lets you introduce in your evaluation pipeline some variations, but also scale. Scale not only on the number of applications that are analyzed, but also scale in terms of data sets that is used, and scale also in terms of classifier that is used or model that you want to test. As a future work, I'm in the process of writing some research report paper. We'll release the code soon. For this item, actually, I would like to get some feedbacks about who would be interesting in this tool. So some ideas, some box analysis. It would be nice to actually do some box analysis at scale also, which is quite busy. We don't do that because we don't have the permission to do that on the platform we used. Okay? That's the only limitation we have. New data sets for sure. New visualization would be great. And things that are related to people from RAN, if you have any trouble about your experimentation, think about the Xug or the PassGuessed even. Okay? Thank you.